Do not expose your paper cone indoor speakers in an outdoor environment, Productions presents. Can anybody see what that might be on the shelf over there? Let's find out. That looks interesting. Let's see if it works. Hello everybody, this is SpeakerFreak95, and here's a eBay find here. I bought this for $12. It had lots of paint splatter on it, and it was very nasty looking, and it was free shipping, and I needed one. And I tell you who inspired me to get this and find one of these was YouTuber Cassette Master. I think he has a 5230, which I think has a really nice speaker in it, which has a dual cone design. Now mine's nice and stylish, the speaker in it. It's a Sanyo speaker, by the way. It has a shiny dust cap on there and a treated surround. I'm not sure what the material is. I didn't get a good look when I had it open. I have completely recapped this thing. Now, I know what you're thinking. If anyone has any experience with Califone machines, they know that they can be one of two things. If they're working, they'll last a lifetime. If they have any problems, they'll be a mess. And this one was a mess in itself, but wasn't too bad to repair. First, when I got it, plugged it in, everything worked. It was as described on the eBay page. But if you turn the volume up to about, let's say, about the, you know, 5 or 6 mark, it would start to oscillate to a really bad bunch. And I figured that might be capacitors, and I opened up, and there were lots of Chinese junk capacitors in there. This model is, unfortunately, made in China, but this is right when they first switched to making things in China, and pretty much it's the same quality control as this unit over here that had got struck by lightning. I haven't made a video of that. I had it on one night, recording thunder, and lightning came in real close, and it never worked since then. So I have since then parted it out. If anybody wants that, there's no speaker and there's a few missing parts on the board, but that's up for grabs. This one was made in Japan. This is right before they switched to Chinese manufacturing. But other than that, the tape mechanism itself works, but the amplifier board's cooked. This is the 5270. Back to what I was saying was, it would oscillate, so I went ahead and checked all the caps, and the majority of them weren't bad, but they were just really cheap, and went ahead and replaced them. They were off-brand, by the way. Actually, I have a few of them to show you. Here's these capacitors, just very cheap. Most of them were out of tolerance. And I've seen this brand before. And you can see how nasty and crusty the bottom is. Probably electrolyte leaking. But I recapped it with audio-grade capacitors. Nichicon, I forget what the series is, but it works really well now. Records well, and the ALC is awesome. I don't have an external microphone to test it right now. I'll add on to this video before I upload it, and we'll be able to see what it's like with an external microphone. The model number is 5270 AV, and it says 10W. What that means is 10 watts. 10 watts audio output power, which is really cool. I took some Goo Gone and some brasso and plastic polish to it, and it looks almost brand new, except for the fact that it's faded. And it's on batteries, but I don't normally like to use it on batteries, but it does work. So here's a good little test. Testing 1, 2, 3, 4. We're testing the Califone 5270 AV tape recorder. It has a 10 watt audio output power, and the VU meter works when it's recording. I don't know if it's normal, but the VU meter doesn't work whenever you're playing back something. And the capacitors on the board that controls this VU meter here was they were both leaky, so I replaced them with new they were 10 microfarad caps, so I replaced them with new 10s. United Nichicon capacitors. This is what it looks like when we peek it. Now, if you can talk softly, it picks it up too. Now, if you turn the ALC off, it doesn't pick it up quite as long. You have to talk really loud for it to register. Actually, I don't think it. Oh yeah, there it is. I do like to use the ALC. Plus, I love that VU meter. I like it a lot better than the analog one that my other one has. It has a lot of background noise using the internal microphone of the motor.
Testing, testing, 1, 2, 3, 4. We're testing the Califone 5270 AV tape recorder. It has a 10-watt audio output power, and the VU meter works when it's recording. I don't know if it's normal, but the VU meter doesn't work whenever you're playing back something. And the capacitors on the board that controls this VU meter here, they were both leaky, so I replaced them with new there were 10 microfarad caps, so I replaced them with new 10s. United Nichicon capacitors. This is what it looks like when we peek it. Now, if you can talk softly, it picks it up too. And if you turn the ALC off,
it doesn't pick it up quite as long. You have to talk really loud for it to register.
I do like to use the ALC. Plus, I love that VU meter. I like it a lot better than the analog one that my other one has.
And, yeah, it works really well. And we can also try it on AC, but it makes no difference. Although the amplifier starts up much quicker on the AC power. Let's hear some music on this machine. This isn't my tape, I found it. It's supposed to be Asia, but it has like other stuff on there, which I found kind of odd. There we go. There still may be some capacitor issue in there, but I'm pretty sure that that's supposed to be moving when it's playing. You have to turn it up quite loud too. I know that's playing slow too. That was recorded too fast. Uh-oh, what am I thinking now? This is a Califone speaker. I've reloaded with a QAM. That's a good way to test the external speaker output. Let's try it out. Rolled. Oops. And that is music being played over this unit. I'm sure Cassette Master would know what's wrong with the VU meter. I did recap it, and I did put the caps in correctly, as far as I know. Recording works really well, and I'm going to go through and open it back up and do some testing, inject some signal into the. There's a little chip that controls that. And it's like a bar-shaped thing, and when you inject like an audio signal into it, it'll light the whole entire thing up. I'm going to check those caps I put in there. They're brand new, but you can still come across duds here and there. Here's what the inject is like. I'm going to get that working again, and if that's the way it's meant to be, then that's fine. But I'm afraid that that's not the way it's supposed to be. Got to hear the internal speaker too. Don't tell me you're too blind to see. Never gonna give you up. Never gonna let you. And this recorder's playing at a good speed, but the music was recorded on this tape too fast, so it sounds too slow. But still, here's the eject. Nice and soft. I didn't even catch that, did I? And if you plug a microphone into it, turn the PA, and you can use it as a PA system. Just hit play, and this will be on. It doesn't oscillate anymore. Plug a microphone in here, and you can plug your external speaker here. Or you can plug an MP3 player into that, or here. It's pretty good. I like it. Thanks for watching, everybody. I'll do a PA test in the next video. Do not expose your paper cone indoor speakers in an outdoor environment, Productions presents. Can anybody see what that might be on the shelf over there? Let's find out. That looks interesting. Let's see if it works. Hello everybody, this is SpeakerFreak95, and here's a eBay find here. I bought this for $12, which I think has a really nice speaker in it, which has a dual cone design. Now mine's nice and stylish, the speaker in it. It's a Sanyo speaker, by the way. It has a shiny dust cap on there, and a treated surround. I'm not sure what the material is. It had lots of paint splatter on it, and it was very nasty looking, and it was free shipping, and I needed one. And I tell you who inspired me to get this and find one of these was YouTuber Cassette Master. I think he has a 5230. I didn't get a good look when I had it open. I have completely recapped this thing. Now, I know what you're thinking. If anyone has any experience with Califone machines, they know that they can be one of two things. If they're working